Da-dun-dun-dun-dun, Schoach World.
Welcome to Schoach World, gamers. Josh here, and as this week draws to a close, I wanted to take a moment to look at this week's new game releases, gaming announcements, and a few news stories. If this is your first time on the channel, do me a favor and hit that subscribe button and join in on the fun. All right, gamers, as always, we will start off with this week's new game releases. And the biggest game release this week was for Star Wars Jedi Survivor. The game released on the PlayStation 5, the PC, and Xbox Series systems, and this is the sequel to Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order. This is a single-player action game and one of the best Star Wars games ever made. It's a day one pickup for me, and I highly recommend playing this game and the original one also. Now, Strayed Lights is a really cool-looking action-adventure game released this week on the Nintendo Switch, the PlayStation 4, the PlayStation 5, the Xbox One, Xbox Series systems, as well as on PC. The gameplay looks fast and fun, and I really like the graphic style they went with. This looks like it might be a really fun game to check out also. Also released this week, Stranded: Alien Dawn. It is a sim survival game where you control the fate of a small marooned group on an alien planet. The game is out now on the PlayStation 4, the PlayStation 5, PC, the Xbox One, and Xbox Series systems. Now, Bramble the Mountain King is a grim adventure game set in a world inspired by dark Nordic fables. The game is a visually stunning adventure survival game, and it is out now on the Nintendo Switch, the PlayStation 4, the PlayStation 5, PC, Xbox One, and Xbox Series systems. Next up, let's take a look at a few gaming announcements. Now, Funko Fusion received a reveal trailer this week. The game is a Funko Pop game that shows a ton of different characters in different worlds, but leaves a lot of questions about what to expect from the actual gameplay. The game has not yet received a release date, but is said to be coming to PC and multiple unspecified consoles. Now, in a rather unexpected announcement this week, we actually received info on a new Call of Duty project. Although this isn't actually a video game, as we received the announcement of the upcoming Call of Duty board game. Now, Might and Magic Clash of Heroes Definitive Edition received an announcement trailer this week. This is an updated version of the original 2009 strategy RPG game, and it is scheduled for release on the Nintendo Switch, the PC, and the PlayStation 4, and it's expected to release by the end of the year. Now, Demon Skin received a release date trailer. The game looks promising. It plays like what looks like kind of a side-scrolling adventure Soulsborne style with 3D graphics. We don't have to wait long. The game is scheduled to release on May 5th for the Nintendo Switch, the PlayStation 5, the PlayStation 4, the Xbox One, and Xbox Series systems, and this game looks really good. I'm looking forward to getting my hands on this title. Alright gamers, let's finish up with a few news stories from this week in gaming. Now, with another week down, the Super Mario movie, it just continues its box office dominance. Still ranked number one for the week and breaking records. We saw it again and had a ton of fun trying to spot all the Easter eggs. If you haven't watched this movie, definitely go watch it. It's a lot of fun. If you have kids, they'll love it also. Now, we got some new info this week on another upcoming gaming handheld. The Rogue Ally with the hashtag PlayAllYourGames was shown. They also announced a showcase for May 11th, where they will give info on pricing availability and the specs on the new portable PC gaming device. I have heard kind of leaks that it looks like it may be around $700, but May 11th, we'll get all the info on the device itself. Now, the Microsoft Activision deal has hit a major roadblock that may actually kill the deal, as UK regulators have decided to block the deal based on fear of its effects on the future of cloud gaming. Microsoft and Activision did say that they are going to appeal the decision, though it looks like this is going to be dragged out for, it could be years. Also, the song Peaches from the Super Mario movie, sung by Jack Black as Bowser while playing his Ludwig von Koopa piano, actually appeared on the Billboard Top 100 music charts. Also, reports of the song being very popular on Spotify, surpassing 74,000 in royalties, was announced. Also, the song is now officially eligible for the Best Song category at the Oscars. The Mario movie just keeps going and going. It's definitely a win. And Miyamoto did announce that they are working on more movies in the future. Alright gamers, that concludes this week in review for the week ending on April 28th. The week started with a demo dropping, allowing us to finally get our hands on Street Fighter VI. Then we got news that Cliff Bleszinski is tossing around the idea of bringing back online first-person shooter Lawbreakers. And the week ended with us getting a ton of new gameplay footage for The Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. But let me know anything we may have missed in the comments, and thanks for joining us today, gamers. Coach World, out.
Please, lend him your power.